look at our galaxy. There are 100 billion stars in our galaxy. Now, take a look at the galaxies of the universe. We can actually count them. In the visible universe, our telescopes have the range to see 100 billion galaxies. Well, how many stars are there in the visible universe? Count them. 100 billion times 100 billion. That is an astronomical number. You have to be supremely arrogant to believe that we are the only ones in town.
Here we are, 25,000 light years away from the center of our galaxy, and our galaxy is over 100,000 light years across. But even that, as large as it is kind of a speck in the cosmic distance scale.
Our Milky Way galaxy may appear big to us, but compared to some others out there, it's actually pretty small.
You turned out all right, didn't you? How do you feel? Let's get the obvious stuff out of the way.
You're not human.
It was tough to get any more obvious than that.
If I had to guess, I'd say you're a program from the machine world. So is he.
So far, so good.
But if that's true, that can mean you're a part of the system. Another kind of control.
Keep going.
I suppose the most obvious question is, how can I trust you?
Bingo. It is a pickle, no doubt about it. Bad news is there's no way if you can really know whether I'm here to help you or not. So it's really up to you. Just have to make up your own damn mind to either accept what I'm going to tell you or reject it. Candy?
Multitudes of cultures and societies that exist throughout the vastness of space. And these societies and cultures have been on and off this planet from the very beginning. It is not just that we, the Pleiadians, have come to assist. We are only one grouping from one star system. There are many who have journeyed here for many reasons. The majority of the extraterrestrials are here for your upliftment, though there are also those who are here for other reasons. We give our version of things only to bring you into higher consciousness. We do not wish to say that this version and only this version is how it is. This whole teaching is designed with a great purpose in mind, and the stories that we tell you are set up to take you to a higher plane of consciousness, That is our intention. You are magnificent beings, members of the family of light, and you come to Earth at this time on assignment to create a shift, to make a change, to assist in the transition. You were told before you came here that there would be much assistance and that at different junctures of your development, different entities would present themselves upon the planet in different capacities to trigger you, fire you up, and remind you not to do it for you. We are one of those triggers, a catalyst. When you hear the name Pleiadians, you feel a connection because we are assisting you in bringing your own information, your own knowing forward. You yourself chose to be here. You are on assignment to bring memory forward and to bring the value of human existence back to the forefront of creation. You are needed. You have been in training for this assignment for lifetimes, and you did not come unprepared. All that you need to know now is inside of you, and it is your task to remember your training. This is not a lifetime when you are going to be taught new information. As we said before, this is the lifetime when you are going to remember what you already know, and we are just here to remind you of it. That is part of our assignment. Humanity is an experiment. Humanity has been designed, as has just about everything else that exists within creation. Prime Creator began experimenting with creation a long time ago in this universe for the purpose of greater self-exploration, self-gratification, and self-expression. Prime Creator brought energies and essences of life, extensions of itself, into this universe and endowed those extensions with the gifts that it had. Prime Creator said to these extensions of itself, "Go out and create and bring all things back to me." Earth was a beautiful place, located on the fringes of one of the galactic systems and easily reached from other galaxies. It was close to many way portals, the highways that exist for energies to travel throughout space. Some of the creator gods were master geneticists. The master geneticists designed various species, some human, some animal, by playing with the varieties of DNA that the sentient civilizations contributed to make Earth into this exchange center of information, this light center, this living library. The original planners of Earth were members of the family of light, beings who worked for and were associated with an aspect of consciousness called light. They designed a place where galaxies would contribute their information and where all would be able to participate and share their specific knowledge. Earth was to be a cosmic library, a place of incredible beauty that experimented with how information could be stored through frequencies and through the genetic process. The project of the living library on Earth was eventually fought over. During Earth's early history, there were wars in space for ownership of this planet. Skirmishes took place, and Earth became a place of duality. Certain creator gods who had the right to do whatever they wanted, because Earth is a free will zone, came in and took over. When the skirmish occurred, a certain group of entities fought in space and won the territory of Earth. These new owners did not want the native Earth species, the humans, to be informed of what took place. Uninformed, the species would be easier to control. That is why light is information and darkness is lack of information. These entities beat out light and Earth became their territory. These new owners who came here 300,000 years ago are the magnificent beings spoken of in your Bible, in the Babylonian and Sumerian tablets, and in texts all over the world. They came to Earth and rearranged the native human species. They rearranged your DNA in order to have you broadcast within a certain limited frequency band whose frequency could feed them and keep them in power. They worked in their laboratories and created versions of humans with a different DNA, the two-stranded double helix DNA. The original DNA pattern was left within the human cells, yet it was not functional. It was split apart, unplugged. We, as Pleiadians, came back through time into what would perhaps be called our past. We came back in order to share a frequency with you, a frequency that each one of you has agreed to carry on this planet in order to change the DNA of the rearranged human race. Earth is assisting, in its own way, the evolution of the universe. It is where the plan begins to blossom, and what happens on Earth is going to affect many, many worlds. The creator gods who have been ruling this planet had the ability to become physical, though mostly they exist in other dimensions. They keep Earth in a certain vibrational frequency while they create emotional trauma to nourish themselves. There are some beings who honor life before everything else. And there are also beings who do not honor life, do not understand their connection to it. Who are these beings who came in and rent asunder the original plans for Earth? Who are these space beings we sometimes refer to as the dark t-shirts? These space beings are part human and part reptilian. We call them the Lizzies because we like to make things a little less emotional and a little humorous so that you don't take them so seriously and get so upset. We are not here to frighten you. We are here to inform you. They have fed off your emotions. One of the big secrets that has been kept from you as a species is the richness and wealth that accompanies emotion. You have been steered away from exploring emotion because through emotion you can figure things out. Your emotions connect you with the spiritual body. The spiritual body, of course, is non-physical, existing on the multidimensional sphere. Why are we telling you all this? Why do you need to know it? You need to know it because the Lizzie reality is re-entering and merging with your dimension. As you awaken to your history, you will begin to open your ancient eyes. These are the eyes of Horus, which see not through the eyes of a human being, but from the point of view of a god. They see the connectedness and purpose of all things, for the ancient eyes are able to see into many realities and to connect the whole picture, the whole history. All of this is to be felt. Allow your brain cells to click into being without your rational conscious mind wanting to define things down to the most minute detail. This experience involves raising a feeling inside yourself, and then, one day, at one moment, in one afternoon, having an overwhelming sense of knowing, having a composition of 1,000 pages long come alive in 5 seconds of divine ecstasy. Before you came into the body, all of you committed to designing events that would fire your codings or blueprints, that would activate your memories. Then you came into the body and you forgot.